I hear the sound of a mighty rushing wind. And it's closer now than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet as Gabriel sounds the call is at the midnight cry. We'll be going home. Are you looking for that day tonight? See, I look around me. I can see the prophecies fulfilling every day. Signs of the time, they're appearing everywhere. Oh, Lord. See, I can almost hear the Father tell the Son, go get my children, oh. You see, at the midnight cry, oh, yes, the bride of Christ shall rise. So get ready when Jesus steps up on a cloud to call his children. Oh yes, the dead in Christ shall rise. Jesus comes again. Oh yes he is. I know he is. See, I look around me and you see, I can see the prophecies fulfilling each and every day. Signs, signs of the times. You see, they're appearing everywhere. I can almost hear the Father as he says, Son, get my children. He's talking about you. He's talking about me. You see, at the midnight cry, yeah, the bride at the midnight cry. your return. Cause at the midnight cry, even so, come Lord Jesus. Cause at the midnight cry, when Jesus steps out on a crowd to call his children, yeah. The dead in Christ shall rise up to meet him in the air. Then those that remain, one of these days, you see, North Carolina, I'm gonna be changed. I'm gonna be changed one day. Oh, yes, I. Cause at the midnight cry, Lord, how we love you in this place. At the midnight cry, adoring him, worshiping him everywhere, then sings my soul.
can glorify your name in all the earth. Glorify. Tonight I pray, fill every one of us. Tonight I pray, touch every one of us. In Jesus' name. Lift those hands to Him, say, and I need Thee, oh, every hour. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. Tonight, bless every one of us, Master. I come to Thee with eyes closed, just a soft whisper. I every hour I need Thee.
Every hour I need Thee.
Oh, bless me now, Savior.
Oh, bless me now,
I come to Thee. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. I know that it's the Spirit of the Lord. There are sweet expressions on its face. There are sweet expressions, and I know they feel the presence of the Lord, and I know they feel the presence of the Lord. Lift those hands, welcoming the Holy Spirit tonight in this place. Sweet. And we welcome you, Holy Spirit. You are the third person of the Trinity. The one who makes Jesus so real to all of us. The one who makes Jesus so real to all of us. Hands uplifted, saints everywhere. Holy Spirit, Thou art welcome in this place. omnipotent Father, omnipotent of mercy and grace, thou art welcome. For in thy presence, Lord, there's healing divine. No other power can heal, Lord, but thine. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome. Lord, in Charlotte, fill all the hungry and the thirsty within. Come restore us, O Father. Please revive us again. The Holy Spirit, thou art welcome here. Holy Spirit, omnipotent, oh, thou art welcome. Tell him thou art welcome. And we're here tonight because of you. And we've come tonight because you drew us here. And we know your presence comes when Jesus is worshipped, O Holy Spirit. We've come to worship the King of Kings. We've come to worship our Master, our Savior, our Redeemer. Eyes closed, saints. Forget all about yourself and troubles now. Forget even who's next to you. Just see Him at the throne. On the throne. Just softly sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the without music, please, just again sing alleluia to the
sing alleluia to the
sing alleluia to the
sing alleluia.
Yeah.
once again with hands uplifted, sing it again everywhere.
And sing
alleluia
to
your hearts lifted all over this auditorium now. Spirit, I pray, don't let one leave this place tonight without a touch on their life. In Jesus' mighty name. And the people said,
amen.
And the people said,
amen.
Are you ready for tonight?
Amen.
Give the Lord a mighty hand of praise for what he's going to do in this place. Worshiping God. There's nothing like worshiping the Lord, is there? Turn to somebody and tell them the Lord will visit you tonight. Give them a handshake. Love them. And you may be seated. It's not often my family comes to a crusade because it's hard with the children. My wife stays home and raises my babies. Thank God for a wife that knows how to raise the children. When God gave me Suzanne, he gave me a good woman. Strong-willed. And the children, well, there's something else. And Joshua, boy, he's something else. On the way here, on the plane this morning, he sang "Nothing is Impossible" to the stewardess on the plane. And I'm told she began to cry while he was singing. He is so ready that he had David Delgado take him out and show him the platform. And he wanted to know where the musicians were and where the drummer was. My fear is he may take over tonight and I'd have to go and sit down. So Joshua, come here. Come here, Joshy. Let him come by himself, David. Come here. He's all fixed up and dressed up and come here. Are you gonna sing a song tonight for the people?
No.
No, honey, you are all ready to sing. Well, first of all, Josh, I tell you what. You just learned how to pray the Lord's Prayer. You wanna tell the people the Lord's Prayer? I'll help you, baby. Oh, honey, I tell you what, if you do it, I'll give you $1.
Daddy, you know, John, when I was watching a movie, he said whoever gets the quietest gets, he had this money, whoever be the quietest.
What?
I'll tell you what.
God.
I don't know what he's talking about, some movie or something.
Listen, if you repeat the Lord's Prayer tonight, I'll give you a dollar and some chocolate. How much chocolate do you want?
I don't know.
You want a lot of it? Do you want a lot of chocolate or a little chocolate?
Well, this morning I almost ate in this house. We got these little candy, and I almost ate them all gone.
You almost ate them all gone? Well, I'll just give you more, okay?
There's almost two left. There are only two more left.
All right. Hold the mic, sweetheart. Come on. Okay, let's do it together. Our Father.
Our Father.
Go ahead.
Which art in heaven.
Yeah.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
And? Lead us.
Lead us. For our father and mother.
No, honey, no. Not lead us from our father and mother, no.
Lead us not.
Into
temptation.
That's it. And deliver us.
And deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Oh, good. All right. Now, these guys are ready. Bruce is ready. And Cheryl is ready. Come on, nothing is impossible. Come on, sweetie. Remember the chocolate?
Yes.
What? A what?
I heard it with the music.
You heard what?
I heard it with the music.
He heard it was, well, honey, they're going to play this music now just for you, okay? Nothing, okay? Here.
I mean, you're going to tell me because I almost forget it, you know.
Little boys. Okay, sweetheart, come on. Nothing.
Nothing. It's impossible when you put your trust in God. Nothing is impossible when you trust in His Word. Heart to the voice of God to be. Is there anything too hard for me?
But put your trust in God alone
and rest upon His Word. Yes, everything. Yes, everything. Yes, everything is possible with God.
Now, sweetheart, look at this. They're all standing. See that? You want to sing it again? Oh. There what? If you'll sing it, thank you. You may be seated, you dear people. If you'll sing it one more time, let's see, what shall I give him? What do you want?
More chocolate.
More chocolate. Okay, it's a deal. Hold the mic. Now you gotta move your hand, honey. You gotta, here, open your jacket like this. Just get that button off there. All right. Now you gotta move your hand. You know what I'm saying?
How come?
Well, you're just, I mean, you don't have to, but it'd just be a good thing to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I don't really want to do it.
A what?
I don't really want to do it.
Oh, honey, just remember the chocolates.
Yeah.
Come on. Move your hand.
I don't want to move my arms.
A what?
I don't want to move my arms, because I just want to be, I just want to keep my hands down.
All right, fine. Sing it again, baby. Come on. Nothing.
Nothing is impossible when you put your trust in God. Nothing is impossible.
Suzanne, bring, and David, can you help Suzanne bring the children up? The whole gang. Come on, Lishi. Come on, darling. Don't be afraid. She doesn't want to come up. This is my Jessica, who's growing faster than I want her to. And she looks so much like her dad. I mean, I tell you, they grow so fast till you think, Lord Jesus, please. Don't do that, but he is. And this is my little Tashi. Honey, why are you crying for? All right, I tell you what, let me give, here, honey. Oh, honey, can I get you? Come here. Baby, I'm your daddy. Let's see if you want to. Well, this is the mother. So my wife, give her a big God bless you. Okay, guys, just stand right here. What? All right. Sue.
It's just a joy to be here again. This was the first experience. I'm not sure how long it's going to be before I'm going to try this one again. I was ready to take two Advil before I started out this morning. But it's exciting to see what God is doing. And I was sitting down beside Daddy Rambo, who I love very, very much. And I remember at the age of 11, just really being drawn to her anointing. Yes. And as Elisha was sitting in my lap, she kept saying, Mommy, I want that lady, I want that lady. And I said, she's drawn to your anointing, Daddy. But it's exciting to see how God is moving amongst his people.
Yes.
Gordon Jensen wrote a song that said he's as close as the mention of his name, and that's the name Jesus. It doesn't matter if you're way, 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 way up in the top bleachers up there or way down on the front row. God is as close as the mention of his name. And he's not going to disappoint you tonight because he loves you and he's going to meet you right where you're at. So just tonight, look to him and just mention the name Jesus. And that presence of God that's within you already as believers will rise up within you. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, baby. Now, by the way, honey, see this man over there? His name is Bob. Bob Harrington. He's got a dollar for you since you sang. You wanna go get it? Go. My wife heard you speak, Bob, when she was 13 years old. Good man. Well, go ahead, give them all a big God bless you. Four children, four and no more. Thank you, Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, as Suzanne has mentioned, we have with us a very special lady, Dottie Rambo. Dottie, we sure love you, my dear. My wife and I have always loved you. You've written some great songs that have blessed millions. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place, and other songs that she's written. I know your body is in pain, but would you mind standing up? Maybe Dave and some of you gentlemen, help her stand and let the people see her. Turn around, sweetheart. Give her a big, big God bless you. Give her a big God bless you. She's blessed us and blessed millions around the world. We love you, sweetheart. And she's come tonight believing God for a miracle. Steve Brock, come, my friend. Daddy, I've asked Steve to sing two or three of your songs tonight, just to bless you. Steve, you know, this precious lady has written a lot of songs. We shall behold him.
She's blessed me many, many times. Many times.
She's written, she has written, We Shall Behold Him, and what else?
Well, she's written a song that I remember the first time I heard was at Channel 40, TBN. I was the reason, the one earthly reason. Tears rolled down my eyes, you sang it. I was the guilty, he was the sacrifice, I was the taker, he was the giver, dying that I go free, the one earthly reason was me. I don't know if you got the message of that, but I was the reason, the one earthly reason, for I was so guilty. But aren't you so glad tonight? He was the sacrifice. I was. He was the giver. Thank you, Dottie. Dying that I go free, the one earthly reason, and I shall forever lift my eyes to Calvary. To view the cross where Jesus died for me. Calvary's the grace that caught my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need. I gotta sing that chorus one more time. Sing it with me. I shall forever to God. All my faults. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for Dottie Rambo. And so my need. Not many years ago, 9 years ago to be exact, tragedy happened in my life. And the song that kept coming to me, I feel the touch of hands so kind and tender. They're leading me in paths I have to trust. You wrote, I'll have no fear, for Jesus, he walks beside me, no matter the problem or the circumstance. I'm sheltered in the arms of God. Surely the top clouds rise. Why he go?
Oh, they know.
They don't worry me. No. Oh, I'm sheltered, safe within the arms of God. He's walking with me. I'm not of her. Nothing on her can harm me. That's what you will. For I'm sheltered in the arms of God. Alvin sang about it a moment ago. Soon I'm gonna hear that call from heaven's portals. I wish it'd be tonight. Come on home, my child. How many know you're ready to go? Do you know you're ready to go for that rapture? It's the last mile you must try. I'll fall asleep, but then I'm gonna wake in God's new heaven. Sheltered safe within the arms of God. That's why I sing it. Hey, let the storms reach high. Let the dark clouds rise. While they don't worry me. Oh, I'm sheltered safe within the arms of God. Nothing on earth can harm me. Oh, I'm sheltered in the arms of God. Yes, I'm sheltered in the arms of God. Lord,
thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want you to give Steve a big God bless you.
And Gary, we love you, my dear. She'll love you.
And I pray the Lord will touch you tonight.
Well, I want you all to say a big welcome to, in my opinion, one of the greatest, most refreshing and funniest preachers in America, Jesse Duplantis. Say hello to people, my friend.
Hello. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm so full of the presence of God. This is the first time I've ever been to a Benny Hinn crusade. And I had some people say, you're kind of quiet. I've just been absorbing. But it's amazing what God will do with the Holy Ghost and some chocolate. And I kind of thought of it, you know. Life's like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. But it's a blessing and an honor to be here and to experience what the Lord is doing. It's amazing. People that are watching my television, you don't believe in miracles, you come to a Benny Hinn crusade. Just come and watch. It's going to get on you. I tell you, it's going to get on you. It is a blessing from God. It's the anointing. It's the anointing of God. I tell you what, it is wonderful. I have just been soaking it up. I was supposed to be here for Thursday night, and I said, this sugar stick, bless God, I'm going to lick it all the way to the end, bless God. I made my mind. Glory to God, I tell you, it's good stuff. Woo! I enjoy myself. Glory to God, I could just hug myself. Just a minute, I'm going to hug myself anyway. Glory to God. Lord. It's dangerous to give a preacher a microphone on this platform. I'm telling you, but it is just such a blessing to see what God is doing. We're able to be real close to, and I'm watching these people as they're interviewing these people, and it's amazing how many miracles happen. Brother Steve just blessed me today. He said, Pastor Hinn, glory to God, a miracle. God touched this lady's broken foot and stuffed toes. I thought, my God, what she put in there, cornbread dressing or something? What's happening here? I like That's good. Lord, I figured if God will knock them toes off, I wanted a bite of that, bless the Lord. Stuffed toes. I like what Pastor Hinn said, stuffed toes. See, that's the sense of humor that God has. Some of you people don't believe God's got a sense of humor. Just look at some of the people he created. Come on. Come on. It's a blessing of the Lord. Oh, it's just wonderful. I am enjoying myself. You know, I'm so busy with my own ministry preaching. I'm either in a church or a convention or I'm in a television studio. And you don't realize how dry you are until you come and sit under this anointing and allow the Spirit of the Lord just refresh you. I went back to my hotel room today, bless God, and I thought for a minute I wasn't going to get there, for, you know, because the Spirit of God was moving. I said, let's just stay till tonight. It don't make a lick of difference to us. Bless God. We'd all sweat it down. Everybody smelled the same, so who cares? You know what I'm saying? Let's just go on with this thing. So anyway, I couldn't sleep, but I couldn't lay down. I was just excited, and the Lord said, Jesse, I said, yes, Lord. He said, you enjoying yourself, huh? I said, I'm a Cajun from New Orleans. I said, Lord, I passed myself a good time here. I want to let you know that. I mean, I'm just enjoying myself, the presence and the anointing of the Lord. Then it dawned on me, if Jesus is the way, you can't get lost. And if he's the truth, you cannot be deceived. And if he's the life, the devil cannot kill you. Because greater is he who is in you, glory, than he who is in the world. That's God Almighty. The power of the Spirit. Somebody shout, somebody! Yeah! If you can't get healed here, you might as well just go home. I tell you, this anointing of the Lord is so wonderful. Just such a blessing. I love the witness and I love the freedom of the Spirit of God. But you got to learn some things in this meetings. See, it's the first time I've ever been. I've only seen Pastor Hinn. In fact, I've preached twice for him in his church. I had never met him personally till last night. I talked to him on the phone, but we had never actually met personally. And I didn't know when he said, call all the ministers up. I thought people were just going to come up. I didn't know, bless God, they're going to knock everybody out the place. You know, I didn't know what God was doing. So I thought they were just going to be, all of a sudden, wham, wham. And I saw them ushers. I said, son, them guys work. And all of a sudden I saw Pastor Jiminy just kind of walked over there like this. I said, he knows something I don't know. He knows something. He kind of looked at me and went, Lord, I had to hold on to the rail. Glory to God. It was so wonderful. I invite you people to enjoy this presence of God. It's a worldwide revival. And let me tell you something. I don't know how anybody could ever not believe in healing when there's so many sick people. And God's given this gift of miracles. Because the Bible said the Holy Spirit gives gifts as he severally wills into Pastor Hinn's ministry, into his life. And it's just the blessing of God. And I thought about it today in my hotel room. Me and the Lord were just having fun. I said, God, this is good. He said, I go to all the meetings. I said, yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's right. I said, that's good, man. I enjoy myself. I just enjoy it. I'm just so full of the joy of the Lord. I'm going to preach Sunday. I feel sorry for them people. I'm going to burn them pews up, bless God. Yeah, glory to God. I tell you, it's just so wonderful to be in his presence. See, I'm not saved enough to be miserable. You know, I've seen some miserably saved people.
Devil been kicking my brains out for 47 years, but just,
my God, you got a lot of brains, you lasted that long. But you come here and just get refreshed in that Spirit of God. And the, you know, and I want to get out the way because I like that miracle of the Spirit of God just flowing. And just wonderful things. I'm an observer, I watch. See, I'd never seen you minister in this setting other than television. I didn't know he was going to say, touch. I didn't know that was coming. And the Lord, God speaks to me. He said, watch it, Jesse, watch it, watch it, watch it. And I thought, no, what? So I'm watching it, you know, what? And he went, and when he went, touch, I went, Jesus, God, what happened? My legs start going, yeah. Whoa. I kind of felt like James Brown. Whoa, I feel you good. Now, yeah. this under the anointing of the Spirit of God. This man's ministry needs to go worldwide in every place, every crack and every crevice of this planet. I'm telling you, it needs to. And paid cash in advance, glory to God. I mean, I tell you, I would invite you to become a part of this ministry. Huh? And it's the first time I experienced it. I'm going to be a part of it. I am a part of it, bless God. Just enjoyed myself when he was receiving the offering. Did you see how many miracles were happening when an offering was received? Now, most people saying, hey, well, ain't blessed God, you know. But not these people. They're getting healed while it's getting free at the same time. I'm telling you, that's miracle working fire God. Then I thought about it today. What people don't understand, and then I'm going to shut up real quick because it's hard, boy. I'm trying to pull it down, but it won't come up. What people don't understand about the Word of God, religion for centuries made it logos or made it written. But see, God never meant it to be logos. He never meant it to be written. He meant it to be spoken. He meant it to be rhema. Rhema. See, religion made it logos and made you read 5 chapters a day and you don't remember any of them. You know. But when the Word of God, see, I understood something about the Word of God. See, John the Beloved in 3 John, he said, to my beloved friend Gaius. And that's about as far as John the Revelator got. Because right then, God arrested his mind. Instead of writing to Gaius, he started writing to me. See, that's right. Because the Bible says all scripture is given by inspiration of God. So know this. Paul, when he started writing to the church at Ephesus, he got Ephesians out one time. Before you know it, God arrested his mind and he started writing to me. So when I don't read the Word of God, I hear the Word of God. See, faith cometh by hearing. I hear the Word of God. See, if you read the Word of God, it sounds like this. Now that's reading the Word of God. Do you get anything out of that? No. But if you hear the Word of God, it sounds like, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Now faith and rhema is being spoken. My Lord, I'm going to buy this tape myself. I'm on it. Yeah! Glory to God. See, it's rhema. And I want to tell you people that are believing for your miracle. God, I got to shut up, Lord. What's Brother Hinn doing? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Okay. When you understand, let me just give you this nugget of truth the Lord gave me. God finishes. Now begin. Everything God's ever done is finished. See, that's why he don't worry about nothing. Because he knows the end result. So he says, by his stripes ye were healed. Before you were sick, you were healed. See, God finished. Now you begin. See, that's what's happening there. God's already finished. Now you begin. That's where that faith comes. The Bible says, now faith is the substance. Now faith is. But the church don't preach that. God says, now faith is. The church says, is faith now? No, no, no. Now faith is. Yeah, I got it. I got it. Is faith now faith is. See, God's finished. If you think Jesus died 2,000 years on the cross, you don't know the Word of God. That was his physical death. Jesus was a lamb slain before the foundations of the earth. Before the earth had ever been created, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost had a meeting. And God said, I think I'll create a universe. And Jehovah and the Holy Ghost said, sound good to us. He said, I'm going to create man in my image. In our likeness. They said, sound good, but man's going to mess up. Born the Holy Spirit. You know, he's the secretary. He's writing down the notes. And I'm going to need somebody to bring man back into a right relationship with me. And Jesus said, I'll go, Father. I am a lamb slain before the foundation of the earth. I'll go, Jesus. I'm going, Father. So you know what the Holy Ghost did? The Holy Ghost said, Jesus, dead. Next order of business, God finished. Now you begin. Created one man and one woman. Could have created all a bunch of race, all of us at one time. He created Adam and Eve and he said, now I'm finished. You begin. I was in Adam. I was short, but I was in Adam. So your miracle in God's mind and in God's eyes and God's voice has already been done. And what God is doing right now, he's looking over the throne at this Colosseum. He said, when they're going to begin? When they're going to begin? I've already finished it. Begin, begin, begin. How do you begin? By faith. He says, suppose it don't work, but suppose it does. But what are we going to do if it don't? What you going to do if it does? I mean, what you got to lose? Can I say one more thing? If you remember anything I've said, remember this. If you doubt your doubts, you won't be a doubter no more, because your doubts have been doubted, because you've learned to doubt your doubts. Only thing the devil can use against you is doubt. God said all things are possible to them that believe it. That correct? So you standing on the word, you people in the wheelchair, said, I'm going to walk. The devil says, he throws doubt in your mind. You're not going to walk. And you tell the devil, I doubt that, devil. And the devil will look at you and say, you can't doubt that. That's doubt. Yeah, but I doubt your doubt. You can't doubt. I doubt your doubt. Then them other devils, they'll start talking to each other. Say, hey, man, this guy over here, he's doubting doubt. How can he doubt doubt? Man, I don't know how he's doubting doubt, but he's doubting doubt. And the devil will go, I doubt it myself. I don't know what to do. You doubt your doubt. If you doubt your doubt, you won't be a doubter no more, because your doubts have been doubted, because you've learned to doubt your doubt. When you understand that, saying, can you give me a scripture for it? Sure. Jesus come out of a boat, and this guy full of devils come running up to him to scare him like he's doing everybody else. And Jesus said, I doubt that. And that just totally confused the devil. He went, see, the devil's so confused, because he's the author of confusion, that he'll ask you what to do. He don't know what to do. The boy has Alzheimer. He don't know. Satan has Alzheimer. If you shut your mouth, he won't remember what to do to you. If you just shut your mouth, Bible said you're snared by the words of your mouth. Just don't say nothing. He don't know what's going on. He just... The devils were so confused in the man, they looked at Jesus and said, can we go on them hogs over there? Jesus said, I'm Jewish. I ain't much on pork. Go ahead. Thousands of hogs got bit to dust. Now, if that was Gentiles that saw that, then he said, wow, ham, pork sausage, wow, pork chops. Glory to God. My God. You like this? Yeah, how you doing? God bless you. Just... So I've been wanting to shake his hands. He'd just come right up to you, put that camera in your face. Man's got great faith. Glory to God. One day, I tell you, it's going to happen. One day, I know what's going to happen. Pastor Hinn going to go, touch, wham, and that boy going down. He going down. Let me just say, Pastor, and I appreciate you allowing me to come to this crusade. And Kathy, I thank you. I'm always so busy. And Kathy says, you need to go. And I hardly, usually when I get a few hours, I go to the house. But I have totally enjoyed myself. I called my office today. They said, boy, you sound different. I went like this. Pull the phone back. Touch! I don't know what happened. I hung up. I'm going to have to find out Monday when they get back. Let me say it again. You people watching my television, come here. You people, come here. You, bring the camera. Come, bring it close to me. You need to experience the ministry of Benny Hinn. I'm not just telling you that. Especially you that are sick. And you that don't believe this stuff, just come look. But don't get too close to the front, because touch will hit you. You understand? I just thought I'd tell you that. I want you to let you know that in advance. You need to experience this. The world needs to experience this. I thank God that I've had the honor and the pleasure of being in the presence of this ministry and this ministry gift. Thank you for allowing me to share a few words. Give Jesus a hand clap. Thank you.
Well, give him a big God bless again.
You are so wonderful. Thank you. Fabulous.
Last night I preached for 15 minutes. Tonight I won't for too long, but I want you to do something right now. The anointing of God is going to descend here very strong and very fast. The choir is going to minister a beautiful song, Lamb of Glory. Steve Brock, if you will, please. And I'm going to ask you to just lift your hands in just a moment and pray, but please listen to me. Ladies and gentlemen, God answers prayer, you know that. I'm going to ask you a question. If you had your child with you tonight who was sick, and suppose the doctors said, we cannot do a thing for your child, you'd pray very hard, won't you, for the child? How many would pray real hard for your baby tonight? You know, there may be someone sitting maybe a few rows back from you who has a child in their arms. What if your mama was sitting next to you and she had cancer? How hard would you pray for your mother? Very hard. What if you were sick yourself? You'd pray, won't you? But you see, thousands of you here tonight have come because you want the presence of God. You're not necessarily physically sick. What I'm going to ask you to do is, while Steve is singing with the choir, I'm going to ask you to lift your hands and pray as hard for someone near you that you don't know, because there's people all around you who are sick. There's somebody maybe two rows away from you dying with cancer, maybe two rows to the other side with a heart disease. Maybe there's somebody with AIDS five rows back from you. Maybe there's somebody with leukemia three or four rows ahead of you. I want you to lift your hands and pray as hard for them as though it's your own brother or your own child, your own mama or your daddy or your brother or sister. Would you do that? And as you do, God's going to answer prayer. So lift your hands and begin calling upon the Lord for somebody else. Come on, lift your hands now. And God will answer. Often He'll heal you when you're praying for somebody else. So lift your voices and pray the entire time Steve sings with the choir. Go ahead, please. Everybody lift your voice and pray.
Oh,
Heal everyone tonight, I pray. Let this be the night everyone will be healed, I pray. In Jesus' name. Brother Ron McMattis, I'm praying for you tonight. This man is a precious Assemblies of God executive minister. When I met with the executive committee of the Assemblies of God, he was there. They found he has cancer. And he came tonight believing God. I said that and prayed for you tonight. This man of God needs a healing. Daddy, I'm praying for you, sweetheart. And I want to remind you, Daddy, and Ron, I want to remind you. Thank you, choir. Even though you know it, I want to remind you. In Genesis, Abraham prayed for Abimelech. God healed him. Abraham had a healing ministry then, didn't he? I want to remind you, Daddy, remind you, Ron, and you, dear people. In Exodus, God said, I am the God that healeth thee. I want to remind you, in Numbers, when the serpents bit the people, God said, whosoever looketh upon that pole with that brazen serpent shall live. The pole symbolic of the cross, the brazen serpent symbolic of Christ becoming our sin. Jesus himself said, as Moses lifted up the serpent, so shall the Son of Man be lifted up. An act of love when he became sin for us. When we see the cross, healing always comes. I want to remind you, precious people, in Leviticus, the goat carried the sin of the people outside the camp as Christ carried our burdens outside the city of Jerusalem. I want to remind you, in Deuteronomy, the Bible says, I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. In the same book, we read Moses at the age of 120 was as strong as when he was 20. His natural force was not abated, nor his eye dim. A promise of healing. I want to remind you in the book of Joshua. Oh, how I love this portion in God's word. Joshua, who knew the power of God. Joshua, who knew the strength of the Lord, stood one day before him, the captain of the host. The Bible declares, it was after that revelation that he received physical strength to possess the land. Special promise of healing. You too can possess the land when you meet Christ. In Judges, Caleb stood and said, I am as strong now as when Moses sent me to spy the land. 80 years old, he was as young as when Moses sent him. In the same book of Judges, Samson received strength against the Philistines. You think about this. Almost every book of the Bible has mighty promises of healing. First and Second Samuel, the plague stopped when David prayed. First Kings, Elijah placed his body upon the child's
body, raised him from the dead. In 2 Kings, Elisha healed the waters in Jericho. This book is full of healing promises. In Job, mighty promise in chapter 33, verse 24 and 25 that declares, I found a ransom, therefore his flesh shall be fresher than a child's. He shall return to the days of his youth. The ransom has been found, saints. The ransom paid. The psalmist said, he healeth all thy diseases. The proverb said, his word is health to all thy flesh. The Song of Solomon said, this is a great promise, he shall lie between my breasts. He's myrrh in the evening time. Myrrh is a healing substance in the Bible. God's word says God gives healing even while we're asleep. Ecclesiastes, a time to heal. Isaiah, he was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for iniquities. With his stripes we are healed. Jeremiah 30:17, I will restore health unto thee and heal thee of thy wounds. I love what Ezekiel says. The shepherds have not fed the flock, therefore are they sick. But tonight, I'm giving you the promises of God, therefore you'll be healed. A mighty promise in Malachi, and the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings. I want to remind you, dear daddy, I want to remind your aunt, and I want to remind you, precious people. The leper came to Jesus in chapter 8 of Matthew and said, if thou wilt, thou canst make me whole. And Jesus said, I will. Daddy, he's still saying, I will tonight. Ron, he's saying, I will. Precious saints, he's saying, I will. All you have to do is believe. In Mark, she said, if I may but touch the hem of his garment. In Luke, Bartimaeus cried, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. He healed him. The Lord healed him. In John, he came to the pool and said, wilt thou be made whole, to the crippled man? Oh, he said, Lord, when the angel stirs the water, someone else gets in before me. But wilt thou be made whole? What a question. And that man was healed. In Acts, silver and gold have I none, such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. In Romans, listen to this. One of the greatest promises of healing in the Bible. In Romans, this promise, how it has strengthened me, how it has kept me. We are more than conquerors through him that loved us. In Corinthians, the body is for the Lord and the Lord is for the body. In Ephesians, the Bible declares, ye are complete in him. In Philippians, Paul the apostle said, something we all have so loved and so repeated, but sometimes we don't even see the fullness of that precious verse. Paul said, I can do all things through Christ who strengtheneth me.
You can get out of that wheelchair tonight. You can command that cancer to leave your body tonight. And I can go through every book of the Bible telling you promises, but I want to remind you, this book declares it. And then the invitation in Revelation, whosoever will, let him come and drink. And lift your hands and tell the Lord, I'm coming, Lord. I'm coming. I'm coming to the fountain where there's healing waters flowing. I'm coming, Lord. I'm coming, Lord. I'm coming, Lord. I'm coming, Lord. As we've gathered in His name, He promised to be with us and choir. And He's here. And He's here. And He's here. His presence we feel. Tonight, all the sick, the blind, the lame, the crippled, those who have been weak and years in pain, when He's here, when He's here, they will bless, they will be cleansed, they will be healed. Jesus, oh Jesus, oh Jesus, dear Jesus, oh Jesus, Your presence makes me whole. Jesus, Lord Jesus, lift your hands to Him, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, Your presence. Saints, when we gather in His name, He promised to be with us. And saints, the Lord is here. The Lord is here. The Lord is here. And tonight you will be blessed. You will be cleansed. And you will be healed. Jesus, oh Jesus, oh Jesus. Everyone standing, worshiping Him now. Jesus, oh Jesus, Your presence. The Lord said, if we gather in His name, and we have tonight, He promised to be with us. And people in Charlotte, He is here. The Lord is here. The Lord is here. And in His presence, tonight, every one of you, you will be blessed. You will be cleansed. Get ready. You will be healed. Your hands, call His name, Jesus. Oh, Jesus, Lord Jesus, blessed Lord Jesus. Let
He's here right now. He's here right now. We don't need to beg. We don't need to wait. He's passing out gifts for you to receive. He's here right now. So let's praise Jesus. So let's praise His name tonight, Jesus. He's passing by. Jesus is passing by. Why don't you reach out and touch the hem of His garment right now? Saints, Jesus is passing by. Jesus is passing by. Reach out and touch the hem of His garment right now. Every hand lifted, please. Jesus is passing by. Jesus is passing by. Reach out and touch the hem of His garment. Jesus, He's passing by. Jesus is passing by. You that are sick, reach out and touch the hem of His garment right now. Jesus is passing by. Jesus is passing by. Just to reach out and touch the hem of His garment. And it passed one day in Galilee.
And they came. And they said, if only we can get near and touch His garment. And many did, and they were healed. He was going in through the gate of Jericho. One day there was a man named Bartimaeus, and Bartimaeus began crying out, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. And the crowd said, be quiet. And he cried the more, Jesus, have mercy on me. And the crowd said, be quiet. And the more they said, be quiet, the louder he shouted. Because you see, my brother and sister, before a miracle comes, opposition comes. But when you're seeking a miracle, you'll break through the opposition and touch the Lord. And Jesus stood still, and they brought the blind man to Him, and He healed him. And a woman came through the press, and a mighty crowd over there that day. She said, only if I can press through that crowd and touch the hem of His garment, I'll be healed. She did. She was healed. And Jairus said to Jesus, oh, Jesus, my little girl is almost at the point of death. evil come, only lay your hand on her, she'll be healed. And on the way, the child died. But that did not stop the Lord, for he's the resurrection and the life. He raised her from the dead. And tonight in Charlotte, I want to remind you, Jesus, the Son of God, is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He has not changed. They cried to them, and he answered them. They cried his name. They called upon his name, and he answered them. Tonight, lift your hands to him and call upon his name, and he will answer you. Like Bartimaeus, call upon the name of Jesus. He'll answer you. He'll stop making walls to hear your prayer. As he did then, he'll do it now. God has not changed. And those that were healed that day, they walked away saying, he touched me, he touched me, he touched me. Now with the choir, everybody singing in faith, he touched me. John the Apostle was on the Isle of Patmos, and he heard a voice one day while in prison in that cave, and there appeared to him the Son of the Living God standing in the midst of the seven candlesticks. And he turned to see the one that spake with him, and when he saw him, he declares and describes his eyes were like fire, his hair like wool, his voice is the sound of many waters. To look upon him was to look upon the very Son of the Living God. And he shone brighter than the very sun in the sky. Very sun in the sky. And John said, when I saw him, I fell at his feet like a dead man. When I saw the Son of God, I fell like a dead man at his feet. And he laid his right hand upon me, and he said, fear not, John. I am the Alpha. I am the Omega. The beginning and the ending, saith the Lord. And tonight here in Charlotte, I want you to know he is still the Alpha. He is still the Omega. Seated at God's right hand tonight is our great high priest. The brightness of God's glory. Precious Son of the Living God. Lift your hands. Close in those eyes. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Son of the living God, and we worship you. whisper, please. Just a soft whisper now.
Hallelujah.
Every eye closed.
Hallelujah.
See him, your Savior, your healer. To whisper hallelujah. Quickly, everyone sick in body, place your hand on your sickness. If it's your legs, place your hands on your legs. If it's your eyes, place your hands on your eyes. If it's your cancer, place your hand where the cancer is. All that is the act of faith. Place your hand on your sickness. If you're sick in body, place your hand on that sickness. All it is the act of faith. Father, I come tonight through the blood of the everlasting covenant, and I ask in Jesus' name, heal your people. And now I step into my office, the office you gave me by thy grace. Satan, I come against you in the name of the one who sent me to stand against you. I come against you in the name of the one whose I am and whom I serve. And I command you, you devil, you spirit of infirmity, you devil of cancer, you devil of diabetes, you devil of heart disease and leukemia, I command you, in Jesus' name, yes, you will obey. Yes, you will obey. I command you in Jesus' name, devil. Let these people hear now, and I mean now. Let every one of them, devil, you've held them bound long enough. You've kept them long enough sick. And my master has died, rose from the dead. My Redeemer has taken that sickness, devil. You have no right holding God's people bound. And I order you, you foul serpent, I order you in Jesus' name, let every one of them go. Let them go. Ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you, under the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I've just had a vision of a serpent literally leaving this building. Now lift your hands and receive your healing from the Lord. Announce to you, the Lord Jesus has just driven the devil away, and Jesus is here to heal you.
Somebody just came out of a wheelchair. Somebody has just been set free from AIDS. Somebody is being set free from crack cocaine. There's a witch in this place, and the devil has just left her. People of God, the anointing on me is so strong, I feel fire from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. Lift your hands, receive your healing. Diabetes is being healed. Leukemia straight ahead of me is being healed. Glaucoma of the eyes is being healed. Stomach cancer is being healed behind me. Arthritis of the arm is being healed to my left. A right eye is opening up. Somebody deaf in both ears is being healed. You devil of deafness, come out! Migraine headaches just been healed. People, please, don't wait for me to call out your healing. Lift your hands and ask the Lord to heal you. Cancer of the throat has just been healed. Brain tumor just been healed. A spinal injury is being healed. People are feeling fire on their body. People are feeling heat on their body. Some of them are feeling electricity throughout their body. That's the power of the Holy Ghost. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead is on you. A lady straight to my right, a growth is leaving your body, lady. If you'll check it, it's gone, honey. It's gone. The Lord is telling me there are 15 men, not only women, 15 men right now have just been set free from drug addiction. Somebody's allergies are being healed. People, lift your hands, receive your healing. Don't wait for me to call it out, just receive it. Somebody with a skin condition, eczema, is being healed. A woman with a lung condition is being healed. A muscle disease is being healed. A blood disease is being healed. A lady unable to have children is feeling a powerful anointing on you. Lady, God is not going to give you one baby, not two babies, not three babies, not four, but five children are coming. Lift your hands. Don't wait for me to call out your healing. Just come on, call upon the Lord. Call upon the Lord. Call upon your healer. Yeah, another bone disease is being healed. Pain is leaving people left and right. Quickly, every person that felt or feels the power of God, and you know the Lord's healed you, get out of your seats and come line up to my left and to my right. Do it now. Do it now. Do it now. Those of you in wheelchairs, come out of that wheelchair in Jesus' name. Move those legs in Jesus' name. Come on, choir, rise and be healed. I mean everything in the organ, Cheryl, everything in the piano, Bruce, everything in the synthesizer, Simeon. Come on, choir, rise and person that felt the power of God, whether I called your healing out or not, many of you felt fire, some felt a warmth, some felt electricity, some felt trembling sensation, some felt nothing but the pain left you. Now come and tell me about it. Don't be like the nine lepers who went and never said thank you. Be like the one leper who came and said thank you, Jesus. Yeah. The Lord said, go tell. The Lord said, go tell. And do it now. It's happening all over this building. The miracles haven't stopped. It's still going to continue all throughout the service. Now lift your hands to heaven. Everybody, come on, choir. There is such power here, people. I will tell you the truth. When I was commanding the devil to leave, I saw a snake about 13, 14 feet long, literally walk off the platform and out that side door right here. Now lift your hands and thank the Lord that He is here. Just once more, please. Choir, it's mighty here tonight. Come on, choir. Rise and be. Run house, what's happening, run house?
This lady has been brought from a nursing home. She hasn't walked for months. These ladies have worked with her. She got out of that wheelchair. She's walking.
Give the Lord a grand hand of praise. Back, sweetheart. There she is. How long have you had this problem, honey?
I had a relapse of myasthenia gravis after cancer, and I've been in a nursing home for 5 months this last year.
What happened tonight?
I started gradually last night. I just started getting stronger. I was coughing until I was so weak that I...
Take your seats, please.
I was coughing until I was so weak that I couldn't. She had a hard to, had to just lift me bodily. It was awful hard to get me up. And I just gradually got stronger. I haven't been able to talk.
Let's walk. Pick up your legs up and down. Give her a big God bless you. Come on back, Holly. For the anointing here. I give you touch of hands so kind and tender. Sing it, Steve.
They're leading me in paths that I must trust.
what's happening to her right now.
I'll have no fear, for Jesus walks beside me.
It's right, God, it's right, sweetheart.
And I'm sheltered in the arms of God.
That's why. I'm so drunk, I'm so drunk. The power of God, my friends, ladies and gentlemen, is all over Dr. Rambo.
And I'm ashamed.
Daddy, such power has flown through you, sweetheart.
No, no. I never felt anything so strong. So strong. I know. God has touched me. God has touched me. I went for my 10th back surgery 2 months ago. Very few people know it. I go again October 10th for another one. I said, Jesus, there's not anything else. They're just cutting on me. They're just cutting on me. And I'm just waiting. I'm just waiting. And when Benny and Susan talked to me and asked me to come down, everybody's been praying and fasting for this. I said, Jesus, this is your night, any way you want it. And I've never been this drunk in my life. I'm so weak.
Daddy, just one line for me. We shall behold him. Just one line. Take your seats. It's a holy moment.
I don't know if I can.
Try.
Lord, two keys. We shall behold him. Oh, we shall behold him. Face to face in all of his glory. Yeah. We shall behold.
Sir, this lady had a growth on the back of her neck. While the power of God was flowing, it fell off her body.
What? Yeah. What did you say?
I had a boil, and I had surgery in February that just kept coming back and coming back, and now it's gone. I felt I was up there, and it was real warm, and then it's gone. Look.
I see the mark, right? I see the mark.
What? It used to always strain, just like pus, and now it's not, you know what I mean? It's just gone. It feels like it's going back into my body, and it's not going to be there, and it's good, and it's gone, and I'm just glad. It's a blessing. I came here expecting a blessing. I just knew the Lord was going to do it.
Take it, honey, take it. Whoa. Pick it up. Take it again, sweetheart. Pick it up, boys. Wow, she says. Hallelujah.
Woo! Oh,
Here goes again, another bonus. Give the Lord a great hand.
Sir. Heart condition, pancreatitis, diabetes, felt the power of God come upon her, all the pain is gone.
The anointing is so strong here, Steve. Ron.
This is Holly and Larry Johnson's mom. She had rheumatoid arthritis severe in her hips.
Larry Johnson, Larry Johnson. Yes, tell me, sir, please.
She had severe rheumatoid arthritis in her hips. She said, I can move them and all the pain is gone.
Totally gone. Why are you crying, honey?
She couldn't run. She couldn't kneel.
This is your mother?
She's claimed her healing since 92. And
are your daughter?
I'm her daughter. And,
who's this? This
my
is
dad.
Your husband, your daddy. And she could not what now?
I'm a nurse, and I went to the doctor with her. She had knots on her knees, and they're gone now. And she can run, she can kneel, she kneeled and thanked God for healing her.
Let's do it, come on. Look at this. Look at this, honey, look at this. I wish you could see the daughter and the husband standing here crying like this, watching, she's watching her mother, he's watching his wife. And now she's gone. That's fantastic what happened to you. What did you feel go through you?
I didn't feel anything. Joan prayed for me and I could...
That's it.
See, sometimes they feel nothing but the problem goes. Thanks for the anointing. That's fantastic. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Pastor, this is a disabled veteran that's been hooked on drugs for 5 years. He felt the power of God come on him strong tonight. He says he's free.
I know. I can see it all over him. Come here, young man. What's happening to you, friend? What's happening to you?
Jesus told me, if I get up here, I'll be free. I had a devil tell me, said, you're not going up tonight.
The devil told you you're not going up there. He's a liar.
An usher stood and told me, said, you're not going up tonight. And I said, Jesus said, if you'll go, I'll meet you. He said, if I'll go, I'll meet you.
Touch! Well, somebody shout hallelujah! Ron, yes.
This lady's had the true test of her healing, Pastor. She's had cancer for 5 years. She got out of this wheelchair. She hasn't walked in 6 months. She stood there while all this was happening. She's doing great. And she hasn't walked in 6 months.
Are you enjoying it?
I am. Yes, it's nice to have fun. Yes.
Honey, I am not in control of this thing.
I know.
Let's walk together. Come on. Give her a big, God bless you. Walk back, honey. She had cancer. And you felt the power of God go through you?
Yes. Oh, it was just like being in a sauna. Just heat come down all over me. And I said, oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
Jesus,
thank God.
Jesus, thanks. Oh, yeah. Thanks. Are you all right?
Oh, yes.
Don't touch me. Because the power of God is flowing through you, I may end up on the floor myself. Huh?
We couldn't have that. No, we couldn't have that.
Touch your Lord, please. Oh, oh. What? Oh, this is her husband. Oh, Lord, bless the husband in Jesus' precious name.
Yes, sir. This gentleman's been delivered from crack cocaine tonight.
Touch. Pick him up. Touch. Pick him up. Never again, devil. Never again, devil. Never again, devil.
Don't you touch him again, devil. In Jesus' mighty name.
What is your name, young man?
Jonathan Randolph, sir.
Jonathan. Jonathan, open your eyes. Turn around like this. Look up. Lift your hands to heaven. Jesus is looking at you. Thank him for that deliverance.
Thank you, Jesus, for deliverance, Lord Jesus. I know you do it for me, Lord Jesus. Thank you so much. I've been praying for it, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Now promise the Lord. Jonathan, promise him to serve him. Tell him you want to be a preacher.
Lord Jesus, I want to be a preacher for you, Lord Jesus. I want to serve you, Lord Jesus. And bring souls to you, Lord Jesus. I know I can do it. Lord Jesus, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you so much.
See those tears come down like that. I love this. Yeah.
Pastor, broken foot. The bone's been deteriorating. They're talking about amputating her foot. She took that brace off and is walking.
My God, look at this. The anointing is all over you, lady. Come here.
Wealth of light.
That's power.
This man from Galilee.
This man from Galilee is Jesus, Lisa. Thanks for the anointing. Thanks for the anointing.
Fibroid tumors, Pastor, the power of God came upon her. She believes.
Thanks for the anointing. Oh! People, please lift your hands and pray in the Spirit. Pick it up.
And in his eyes,
lady, it's power on you. Touch. Oh! Run.
Preston, bone cancer. She got out of this wheelchair tonight.
Look at these people. Look at these people. Look, look, look. God's power all over her. Yes, I will be. And you came out of the wheelchair. Let's walk. Come here. Walk, honey, walk. Give her a big God bless you, say. I didn't do it. Thanks for the anointing of the Holy Ghost.
Because of a car accident, disc deteriorating in her neck, power of God came upon her, the pain
was
gone. She got out of a wheelchair and took off a brace, Pastor. She's been suffering from bone cancer.
Lord Jesus, thanks for the anointing. Thanks for the Holy Spirit here. I give you praise. Is this her wheelchair right there? Run, house. Is that her wheelchair?
Yes,
bring it here.
My strength is really gone.
That was your wheelchair. Let's walk, honey.
But just
people, will you give the Lord a great hand for these miracles? Let's keep walking. Let's keep walking. Look at this. Look at this. Jesse, if it was only for this miracle, it'd be worth it, right? Somebody shout hallelujah! Thanks for the anointing. I love this. Stand up, choir. Sing it with Lisa. There is strength in the name of the Lord. Play, musicians.
There is power in the name of the Lord.
Thank you.
legs for 3 years. I had cerebral palsy as a baby, and 3 years ago I totally lost the ability to walk. And I've been walking with a cane and in my wheelchair, and God's totally healed my back. All my pain is gone. Look, all my pain is gone. I'm totally delivered. I'm free. Glory to God.
My goodness, she's so happy. The pain is totally gone.
The pain is totally gone. Totally gone. There's no pain. No pain. And I've been in such pain for 3 years.
Thanks. Thanks. People, you gotta shout hallelujah. You just gotta do it. Bring my dear friend, superintendent. Stretch your hands towards this man. Father, heal him. Remove this cancer. Totally. In Jesus' name. Totally. Come on, go on. Father, I rebuke it. I rebuke this cancer in Jesus' name. Go! Go! Pray in the spirit, people. Remove it, Jesus. Burn it out. Touch. Yeah. Let him go. Let him go. You spirit of cancer, let him go. You leave his body now. Go. Hallelujah. I want David, Kent, go get my little boy. I want to lay my hands on my little boy. I want God to use him from a young age. Jessica and Tasha, come here. Father, you promised me that my girls would serve you. I remind you of that promise. I ask you tonight to touch my Jesse, my Tasha. For your name's sake, Holy. Now, Lord, the anointing. Oh, the anointing. Bring him here. He's still awake. Stretch your hands towards my Joshua. Take his life and use him, Lord. From a young age, use him. Protect him. Keep him as the apple of the eye. Use him, Lord.
He's feeling God's presence, people.
Sweetheart, you know Jesus is touching you. You want to ask Him to use you? Lord, Master, use my boy. In your mighty name. Lord, Master, I give him to you. Protect him with your blood. One of these days, I pray he'll carry on the healing ministry. In Jesus' name.
In a simple carpenter, you see the Son of God. If you would choose to lose when you could win,
listen to this.
If you will give your life away for nothing in return, then you are where my kingdom is.
That's what Jesus said.
Upon this rock, I will build my kingdom. And on this rock, forever and ever it shall stand. And all the powers of hell itself shall nevermore prevail against it. For Satan's thrones are built on seeking strength.
By this anointed service from Charlotte, North Carolina. If so, please take a moment to let us know. Write Benny Hinn Ministries, P.O. Box 90, Orlando, Florida 32802. Also, now available on video are the Thursday and Friday evening services from Detroit, Michigan. If you've enjoyed Charlotte, you won't want to miss these dynamic miracles, which are sure to build your faith. For more information on these and other products by Benny Hinn, you may call 407-292-4200 or write. We look forward to hearing from you. And remember, this is your day for a miracle.